All right, welcome back to the last lesson of this week. We're going to wrap up section 10.2, which is using tangent lines to solve various problems. So our first example, we are told, hey, line M is tangent to circle T at B. Line N is tangent to circle T at C. Use this information to find the value of x. So even though it's not marked in the figure, because we're told that these two lines are tangent, that means I do get to add something to my figure, which is that we are dealing with some right angles. Now, one of the things I'm going to pull out of my hat from a previous lesson is, if I take a look at, and I'm going to highlight this figure. This is a quadrilateral. And because it's a quadrilateral, I know that all four angles have to add to 360 degrees. Okay, I know that to be true. And so since I know, because I'm told, that these two lines are tangent, I know that these two angles are 90 degrees each. I know that angle T is 135, so I can write a simple equation. X plus 2 times 90 degrees is 180 degrees, plus 135 degrees has to be equal to 360 degrees. And so when I combine like terms and then subtract, I find that the value of x is, if I've done my math right, 45 degrees. Okay, now our next problem. We were told in our notes, hey, use this figure for both of these questions. So let's start with part A. Is line MP tangent to circle N? So I don't need to focus on this part of the figure. I only need to look at this. Is MP tangent to circle N? Well, if I take a look at the figure that I'm given, I have a triangle. And similar to our previous problem, I know that the three angles in the triangle have to add to 180. So is 58 plus 33 plus my unknown angle at M equal to 180. Okay, well, this would have to be 90 in order for this to be true. So that's our big question. Is X equal to 90? Well, what we find is that if I add these together and subtract, the answer is no. X would be 89 degrees, not 90. So we're going to use that to say no, because angle M is not 90 degrees. Okay, so I've got my math there to help justify that conclusion. Okay, for part B, we're told if LK, and I'm pointing way over here, if LK is tangent to N. If LK is tangent to N, so if it is, that means this would be a right angle, then what is the value of KN? So that's our big question here, okay? What is the value of KN? That's our question, okay? Well, I'm dealing with a right triangle, and the right triangle, when we're dealing with side lengths, has to follow the Pythagorean theorem. So if I know that this radius is 9, then that makes this radius also 9. So we're going to set this up. 9 squared, all right, let me use my purple pen here. 9 squared plus x plus 5 squared has to be equal to, and I have to add these two segments together. Okay, well, what is x minus 1 plus 9. X minus 1 plus 9 is going to be x plus 8 squared. Okay, let me say that again. This entire segment, Kn, Kn is going to be x minus 1 plus 9, which is x plus 8. So, for the full triangle, I'm going to use the Pythagorean theorem here. Remember, exponents don't distribute, so we're going to have to expand. 9 squared is 81. This is going to be x plus 5 times x plus 5, and then x plus 8 times x plus 8. We're going to distribute correctly. So 81 plus, and this is going to be x squared plus 10x plus 25, and this side is going to be x squared plus 16x plus 64. So when I start to combine like terms, I notice, hey, my x squares, they're going to cancel each other out because they're going to add to zero. I'm going to set my x's to one side, my constants to the other side, right? So I want a positive leading coefficient. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to subtract 10x here. And because I'm running out of space, I'm going to also subtract 64 here. And what we end up with on the left is 81 plus 25 minus 64. That is equal to 42. 16 minus 10 is 6x. That makes x equal to 7. All right, so we're going to wrap up section 10.2. Now, my notes, I got them out of order from your notes, so I'm going to hold off on that for a second. We'll come back to that theorem, and we're going to take a look at this problem. Okay, now, this is what I'm given. Okay, the figure says that I've got radii that are congruent, that I'm dealing with two right angles, which makes yz and xz tangents. Okay, so because of the information that I'm given, xz and yz are tangents. Okay, now we're told if tx is 12, that would also make ty 12, and tz is 20. This entire length here, that entire length there is 20. How do I use that to find the length of xz and yz? Well, if we notice, hey, I've got a right triangle. Okay, so I'm going to draw what I've got here. I know that this is 20, this is 12, this is my unknown. That means I do get to use the Pythagorean theorem. And if I do this right, I should notice something kind of interesting. So x squared plus 12 squared equals 20 squared. That means x squared plus 144 is equal to 400. Subtract 400 minus 144 is 256. And then the square root of 256 is 16. Okay, so that makes this side length here 16. That was xz. And then if I look at my second triangle, and some of you are going, oh, why is she doing this? I already know. Well, this is the point. Okay, if this is 12 and this is 20, then it's just the same figure, which means Pythagorean theorem would hold again, and yz is also 16. So we're going to answer our question. Xz equals the same length as yz, which is 16 units. Okay, now this is the basis for our next theorem. Okay, now let me flip my page back over. Our book, again, for whatever reason, calls it theorem 10-2. The name doesn't matter. What matters is we're told if two segments with a common endpoint outside the circle, are tangent to the circle, then those segments are congruent. Okay, so I like my pictures. So I've got a circle with tangents. If two segments with a common exterior point, so that's my exterior point there, I might call this point A. This would be point B, this would be point C. If two segments with a common exterior point to a circle are tangent to that circle, which means they would be right angles, then those segments are congruent. So in this case, because I know already that radii are congruent and tangents form right angles, then this theorem allows me to go, okay, so this segment that's tangent at B is congruent to this segment that's tangent at C because they both share the same endpoint on the outside of the circle. Now, this isn't the best picture that I've drawn, but that's something to keep in mind. In this case, AB is going to be congruent to AC. So we're going to use that as a guide for our last problem. Okay, if I want to find perimeter. Okay, now I love this problem because it almost feels a little intimidating, but I just got to remember a couple of things. Really, one thing. That previous theorem. When I take a look at the facts that I'm given, this segment here and here are both tangent and meet at point A, which means these two segments are congruent. So if one segment is 7, the other segment is 7. Let me switch colors. Some of you don't need that. You're already like, oh, I got it. Just move on, please. I like my colors. So same thing over here for B, that this segment and this segment are both tangent to the circle. They meet at that same exterior endpoint. So if this segment's 2, then this segment is also 2. This segment and this segment are both perpendicular to the circle, which means they're tangent, meeting at a common endpoint. So if this segment is 3, this segment is also 3. And then finally, this segment and this segment are both tangent to the circle with a common exterior point. So if this segment is 6, this segment is also 6. So that's important to know as we go to answer the question. If I want to know what's the perimeter, I need to know the measure of each segment. So I'm going to add all those up. I've got 2 segments that are 7, 2 segments that are 2, 2 segments that are 3, and 2 segments that are 6. So 14 plus 4 plus 6 plus 12, have to add 2. Dun, dun, dun. What is it? 10, 24 plus 12, which is 36 units. All right, guys, that is the end of section 10.2. I want you to tackle that homework. Make sure you turn it in through turnitin.com and then go and complete the problem of the week, which will count as a small quiz grade. Hit me up during office hours and I will talk to you guys soon.